Today we're going to be looking at how to set up an eGPU on Mac. An external graphics processor can give your Mac additional graphics performance for gaming applications. For reference, this is the Blackmagic eGPU. Let's go about setting up this eGPU for Mac gaming. The first thing you need to do is connect the eGPU's Thunderbolt 3 cable directly to the Thunderbolt 3 port on your Mac. Make sure that the thing is obviously connected to power. And some people are right there and then will think that they're good to go. Now, while you are connected like this with just the eGPU and your Mac, you are not getting the full performance enhancements. In order to get that, you have to connect an external display to your eGPU. We connect the HDMI from the back of the display and you connect it directly into the back of the eGPU. To make sure your eGPU is connected correctly to your Mac, you should see the eGPU item in the top right menu bar, or you can go to About This Mac and under the graphics section, it should display your eGPU's graphics card. Since applications and games default to the GPU associated with the primary display, you should also make sure that your external monitor is set as the primary display. So to do this, go to System Preferences, then Displays, then select the Arrangement tab. Make sure that Mirror Displays is unchecked. From here, drag the white menu bar to the box that represents the display that's attached to the eGPU. What you can also do to make sure that your Mac is fully utilizing an eGPU is to actually go to the game itself. For this reference, let's go with Divinity Original Sin 2. You right click on the game, then press Get Info, and then go Prefer External eGPU. This is basically going to tell your Mac that, hey, I want to be using the power of this eGPU the whole time. I don't want to be using my Mac's actual graphics. Now, not every game officially supports eGPUs. But even without eGPU support, most macOS games will still see a boost in performance. It's up to developers if they want to support eGPUs and make an official statement about this, or it's up to you to actually check with developers if they are supporting this feature. For example, Feral Interactive publicly stated that Rise of the Tomb Raider supports eGPUs, and also Lorion Studios publicly stated that their game, Divinity Original Sin 2, officially supports this feature. But yeah, that is pretty much how to set up an eGPU on Mac. This is a very small video, but some of you have actually requested this, so I thought I would clear some of the misconceptions and give you some tips on how to best utilize this. If you want to see the performance enhancements that you can expect from an eGPU, be sure to follow the video that is over here right now. It's right there. That will show you the benefits of an eGPU and then without, and how your frame rate will be better or whatever. So you can click that.